The training course for the GIs will be across 3 days. Each day will consist out of a learning session and a practical session. The first day learning session will be about the introduction of the course and then GIS theoretical background. It is important for me to include this in a GIS course because this will provide the basis of GIS work in the future. The theoretical background will also include some disaster management concepts that will help in the execution of the practicals later on. Practical will start with a compilation of a GIS project. For me, this is almost the most important part of any GIS project. The problems that we are going to solve using GIS is to identify areas of possible landslides in the Makwa district in South Africa. And then a popular topic nowadays is to identify high-risk areas for a COVID-19 outbreak in Bloemfontein. The software that we're going to use is QGIS, and we will use this to execute our, or to get the solution to our stated problems. The first day we will look at the creation of a QGIS project. How do you add data in your project? We will look at creating symbology using QGIS. Okay, this will be our first day. The second day we'll also look at learning and some practical exercises. The learning will again look at the theoretical background of GIS and disaster management. The practical will again look at QGIS basics, but then we will start with our project as indicated in day one. We will create a database for our problem in the landslides in the Namakwa district, and then also identification of high-risk areas in Bloemfontein for COVID outbreak. They will look at the acquisition of relevant data, and I will mostly look at data that is readily available, creation of the data, the management of the data, the use of management of attribute table in QGIS. We will look at working with vector and raster data, and the due package and the file due database. How do you use QGIS to work with a file due database? In spatial analysis, we will try to answer the next questions. Roads impacted by possible landslides, nearest medical facilities to high risk areas, number of people at risk in high risk areas. In day three, we will continue our practical. We will also again look at the spatial analysis that we have done at the during the previous day, but we will also this day look at visualization of spatial data. And again, we will use QGIS, and I will show an example how you can use the same data in an Excel spreadsheet as well to visualize your data. This assignment will then contribute to a certificate of completion of the course.